Hello everyone. Today we start our unit number 1, design process and design of simple machine element. The weightage for this unit from the examination point of view is 16 mark. Out of that, 10 mark is for the in semester exam, where question number 1 and question number 2 will be on unit number 1, and remaining 6 mark that will be at the end semester examination for 6 mark. In this unit we have to start with what is a machine design, need of the design, design process, and thereafter we have to go for standards, codes, preferred series, what is the factor of safety, what are the different factors considered for the selection of factor of safety, and then we will go for the design of simple machine elements like design of the quarter joint, design of the knuckle joint, design for eccentric loading, design for the curve beam, and last we have to conclude this topic with the different types of the hand or foot operated. Now we start with the design. What is a design? Design is a systematic way for optimization of the cost. Students, whenever we have to go for optimization of the cost of any of the equipment or any of the component, for that design is a basic step. Unless and until design properly, we can't optimize the cost of any component. We can also say design is a plan for construction of an object, for the development of any of the object, for the development of the any of that of this equipment. So we have to start with the design of the simple components, and we have to make the assembly of these simple components which may convert it into the final object. Design is also called as a to satisfy the customer's needs. Whatever requirement of the customer, whatever customer expect from the existing component, so that requirement can be satisfied by the modification in existing component. That is also called as a design. Design refers to create something new. Whenever we have to develop something new, or whenever we have to propose something new, so for that we required design or knowledge of the design. So this is the brief introduction to the design, or we can say the machine design. Then coming towards the some common words related to the design. So we heard the word designer, design process, mechanical engineering design, machine design, design of the machine element, etc. Students, the person who involves the design or who design the machine component is called as a designer. Then design process is the process of designer sequence, or we can say designer plan of various activity to reach the final component is called as a design process. The term mechanical engineering design refers to select the material, design of the component and system of mechanical nature. And last, the machine design, which deals with the design of the machine, their mechanism and element. Now we'll go for the next need of the design, or what is the necessity of the design. Under this head, the basic requirement is functional requirement of the component, use of the comfort, safety, appearance, and cost of optimization. functional requirement. So in this, the design of the product should satisfy the purpose for the which it is made. Any component you can take. You take the example of the washing machine. The purpose also of washing machine is to wash the clothes, and that is the functional requirement of that washing machine. Next, use of the comfort. The product design should be user friendly and easy to operate. So here the comfort is important. We can take the example of various automobiles, various cars, where the comfort level is different for the different manufacturer. So that is the one we can say the necessity of the design. Safety. The product is so designed that it should not be harm to the user and should not have any failure for the specific time of the period. Whatever component, whatever equipment or whatever vehicle, so it is designed for the safety. It should not be failed in a specific period of the time. It should not be harm to the user, and that is the, again we can say, the need for the design. Appearance. The component designed for aesthetic and ergonomic consideration. Aesthetic stands for appearance of that of this product. The component deals with the or appeals in a market with the appearance. So aesthetic consideration is very much important factor as a design point of view. The second one is the ergonomic consideration of the design. Ergonomic stands for satisfaction to the customer, or we can say it is a functional requirement to the customer. And last one is the cost optimization. Whatever product we want, that will be available with optimized cost. Then customer that can attract towards that component. If the cost is low, then the person or the customer attracts toward the component. If the component is good and if the cost is very high, then it will affect the sustainability of that component in the market. And therefore, so these 3 to 4, 5 important considerations stands for the need for the design of any of that of this component, any of that of this machine equipment. I will give the example of day-to-day life. Students, take the example of that of this your sitting bench. Take the example of the sitting bench. So which is meant for the functional requirement, meant for sitting of the 2 students or 3 students in a class. The components required for the bench are the wooden plates, then angle, then nuts, bolts. So like this, different components are required. Then what is the use of comfort? So in this example, so the comfort is that whatever 2 persons are sitting, they feel comfort. There will be the no harm from that of this body of that of this bench. So there will be the no any of the failure of the bench. If the instead of the 2 person, 3 persons are sitting on the bench. So that is a case of that of this use of the comfort. Then appearance. Whenever we manufacture that bench, it should be attractive so that one can purchase it. So this is a part of that of this design. Last but not the least, the cost optimization. So what is the role of the designer? So if one can go for the design of that of this bench, and if a person who does not go with the design consideration while fabricating the bench. So see here, so we can explain what is the need of that of this design, or why there is a necessity of the design. So designer knows for what purpose the bench is going to design. Two persons are sitting, that means approximately he considers 75 kg weight of each person, so he designed the bench with the 150 kg. By considering the suitable factor of safety, either 1.5 or the 2, so he will calculate the net load on the bench. With this net load on the bench, he can calculate the thickness of that of this wooden plate and that of the channel or the angle required for fabricating work or body of that of this bench, so that irrespective of that of this any worse condition, if the bench is designed for the two person, but so unfortunately if the third person is there, or the four persons are sitting, or few persons are standing on the bench, still the bench gives a safety against the overload. So that is the that can be used only by the design, or at the end will found the bench is safe against the overload, and it is with available in a market with the optimized cost. In the second side, if the bench is not designed by the any designer, randomly he can pick the wooden plates of the thickness as he wish. Either the thickness of the plates he choose with the larger thickness, so, or he may choose the thickness with the lower side because he want to reduce the cost. Same is the case for that of these channels, pipes, or that of these angles. Less strength material he may select, or the overstrained material he may select. And finally, there are the only two possibilities: either he design or whatever bench he fabricate, either its cost is too large or its cost is too low. As its cost is too low, there may be the every possibility that it cannot protected against the overload. Or if its cost is too large, so unnecessarily he paid more for the material cost because that is not the required as per the calculation or as per the design calculation. So here the one conclusion is made: the design is the beginning step of every design of that of this any component, so which gives the systematic way for the optimization of that of this cost. Now coming towards the next subtopic from this unit, general procedure in machine design. The layout shows the step by step procedure or activities for the machine design. The first step is need or aim. Second, synthesis. Next, analysis of the forces. Next, material selection. Next one, design of elements. Next one, modification. Thereafter, detailed drawing. And last one is a production of that machine element. So here this is the basic procedure we have to follow for the design of the any machine component. In a first step, define or need or aim. So here first of all we have to define the design problem or make a complete statement of the problem indicating the need or purpose for which the component is to be made. So this is the first step. So we have to see the need of that of this component. What is the aim? What is the problem statement? That first of all we have to decide. In the next step, synthesis. Synthesis means selecting the possible mechanism or group of mechanism which will give the desired motion or output. For example, we are manufacturing the IC engine cylinder. So we know the IC engine cylinder and its a component: cylinder, piston, inlet valve, outlet valve. Then which mechanism which required for operating the inlet and outlet valve, whatever different mechanisms which works the inlet and outlet valve, or whatever mechanism requires to reciprocate the piston, so up and the down movement or piston reciprocating motion of the piston or rotary motion of that of this crank converted into the reciprocating motion of the piston, what are the different possible mechanism, that is a part of synthesis. In analysis of the forces, so here we have to find out the forces acting on each member of the component and motion transmitted by each member. Whatever different components of that of this IC engine, like cylinder, piston, piston rod, connecting rod, then inlet and outlet valve. So whatever different forces acting on each and every member, so that we have to analyze. Thereafter, selection of the material. Whatever listed component of that of this, any of that of this machine component here, we have to select the best suitable material for each member of the component. And here in a cylinder, for example, cylinder which is made up with the cast iron, piston, again we can select the appropriate material. Then connecting rod is there, crank is there, inlet and exhaust valve is there. So we have to select the suitable material as per the requirement from the material family. So that is the next step, the selection of the proper material. Design element. In a design element, that means we have to find out the shape, size of the component. So here, shape and size of each member of the component by considering the forces acting on the member and permissible stresses for the use of material. So different stresses can be calculated, and after calculating the stresses, thereafter we'll proceed for obtaining the final dimensions of that of this component. Next step is a modification. Here in a modification, we can modify the shape and size of the component as per the past experience of the designer. The modification may also reduce the overall cost of the manufacturing. So if any design modification is there with the existing and proposed component, so we can do it so that it will ultimately affect on a cost of that of this component. After modification, the next step is detailed drawing. So here, whatever different components we listed, for that we can draw the detailed working drawing, so that with the help of that of this working drawing, we can start the manufacturing of that of this component. So and last step is the production of that of this the components. After getting that of this working drawing, so the component is manufactured and assembled in a workshop. So that is the procedure in a machine design we have to follow, or we can say this is the general procedure in a machine design. So now next subtopic from this topic is a factor of safety. Factor of safety, so is the most important term required before starting of the any of that of this machine component or automobile component. It is a factors against the overload, or it is a safety factor against the overload. We can also say it is necessary to keep the stress lower than the maximum or ultimate stress at which the failure of the material takes place. This is the stress is called the design stress or working stress. Hence, the designer always keep some reverse strength in the form of factor of safety. In general, the factor of safety is defined as the working stress, or we can say the factor of safety is a ratio of maximum stress to the working stress. Also, it can be defined as strength of the component to the stress in the component due to the actual load. So students, so we know that there are the two different materials are there. We know in a strength of the material, stress strain curve for the brittle material and stress strain curve for the ductile material. Example for the ductile material is an mild steel or the carbon steel. Our example of that of this brittle material is a cast iron. So factor of safety is different for the different material. The figure shows the stress strain curve for the figure D shows the stress strain curve for the brittle material and E shows the stress strain curve for the ductile material. We know the nature of the graph. For the brittle material, the ultimate tensile stress is the failure criteria, and for the ductile material, yield strength is the failure criteria we consider. And therefore, on the basis of that of this material to be selected, factor of safety is again defined. So by two ways, for brittle material, factor of safety is a ratio of ultimate stress to the working stress, because ultimate tensile strength is the failure criteria. And second, for ductile material, the factor of safety is a ratio of yield tensile strain to the working strain, because the yield tensile strength is the failure criteria in a design of that of this machine component. Now, the next step, after knowing the what is the importance of the factor of safety, what is the factor of safety for the ductile material, or how the factor of safety is defined for the ductile material or brittle material. Thereafter, next and the most important step is to select the factor or factors considered for selection of the factor of safety. So there are many factors are considered while designing the any of the machine component. So designer requires to concentrate this factor, because the factor of safety is completely chosen by the designer before going to the design. If any wrong selection of the factor of safety, which may affect the cost, which may affect the that means reliability, or which may affect the performance of that of this product. So minimum factors considered for the selection of the factor of safety is listed below. I'll give the some brief explanation about the these factor listed below. The first factor is a kind of material. We know there are the different types of the material. Material may be the homogeneous, material may be the non-homogeneous. Homogeneous material is nothing but the ductile material, and the non-homogeneous material is nothing but the brittle material. Ductile material, where the strength is good, and here if the material strength is good, so the low value of the factor of safety is required. Whereas brittle material, the strength is low, and therefore higher value of the factor of safety needs to choose. Next factor is the kind of the load, the fatigue load and the static load. Fatigue load is nothing but the continuous load or the cyclic load. Example, shaft running in a bearing is a fatigue load, and static load so is a stationary load, so not in a motion. The static load, the stationary load, whenever the component is designed for the fatigue load or cyclic load, the higher value of the factor of safety is recommended, whereas lower value of the factor of safety is required for the static load. Next one is the nature of stress distribution. So here the two stripes of the stress distributions are there: non-uniform stress distribution and uniform stress distribution. Non-uniform stress distribution, that means high peaks and the peaks values are there, high value of the stress, low value of the stress, and if you calculate the average value, so in that case, so whenever this is the nature of that of this stress distribution, then in that application low value of the factor of safety is required. Whereas uniformly distributed stresses, So the stress is a constant, so will require higher value of the factor of safety. Next one is the danger to the life and the property. So students, some of the application where risk is more, in that application we can take the example of the nuclear power plant, or we can take the example of the boiler. So in the application where the risk is more, higher value of the factor of safety is to be selected. Where the risk of the severity is less, then less value of the factor of safety we can select. How? So here, whenever the boiler plant, the hundreds or thousands of the person working outside that with this boiler, and if the boiler fails, if the factor of safety is not properly chosen, then the plant will fail, and if the plant will fail, it will not the loss of the property, but hundreds or thousands of the person working outside the plant, they may lose their life. And therefore, whenever such a severity is more, then always select the higher value of the factor of safety. And whenever the severity of risk is low, then select the lower value of the factor of safety. Next one is the quality of the production. If good quality of the component have less defect, as we say, for example, surface finish, if the component manufactured with a very high accuracy, very high surface finish, less defects are there. Less defects, less irregularities, and less effect of the stress concentration, that means lower value of that risk factor of safety is required whenever high surface finish is there. But if the surface finish is not proper, so the surface is not smooth, irregularities on a surface finish, which may cause the effect of that stress concentration and which may cause the failure of the component. And therefore, under such circumstances, we have to select the higher value of the factor of safety. Next one is reliability. There is a relation between reliability, cost, and the factor of safety. Very, very important that means factor for the optimization of the cost, for the life of that of this component, and for the optimum value of the factor of safety. Reliability is high. If the reliability is required high, the factor of safety is high. And as the factor of safety is high, reliability is high, the cost of that of this component is high. Vice versa, if low value of the factor of safety, low reliability, because the component is designed for the low reliability, then lower value of the factor of safety is to be chosen. And if the reliability is less, then the cost of that of this component is less. And last, the testing of the components. So we know the components from manufacture. After manufacturing of the every component, it is tested. It is tested before it is put into the operation. But most of the time, the applications or examples like aircraft, examples like the boiler, nuclear power plant, after manufacturing, it cannot be tested directly. So in this case, the risk is more if the failure is there, and the component which cannot be tested or component which can be tested by the prototype model, so in that case the value of the factor of safety is selected to the higher side. So these are the minimum factors consider for selection of the factor of safety before going to the design or before going to the any design of that of these components. So every designer's role is to choose appropriate factor of safety, then and then he will get the correct design. Otherwise, either his design may fail under working condition, or the cost of the component may increase because overvalue of that of this factor of safety. Then, as like the service factor, one more factor is introduced, which is called as a service factor. also called as a application factor or also called as a overload factor. Service factor or overload factor is defined as maximum value of the torque or load on a component to the average value of the torque or load on a component. So this is the again one more factor which accommodate for the overload, and that factor is considered in addition to that factor of safety for most of that of this component design. So I'll give the one example. So we know the different machine component that receives the power from electric motor, that receives the power from the IC engine, that receives the power from the turbine, or that receives the power from any other source. Whatever power receives from the source to that of this machine component, source to the machine component, for example, electric motor to that of this machine component, turbine to the machine component, the IC engine to the machine component, and while giving the power, some sort of that of this overload may there while transmitting the power from source to that of this machine component. So starting torque is more than the average torque, that is the relation we know, and therefore to accommodate this overload factor, a factor introduced is called as service factor. So this is about today's lecture. So today we start with the introduction to the design, different names or names for the machine design, necessity of that of this machine design. Thereafter we see in the general procedure for that of this machine design, factor of safety, factors considered for the selection of the factor of safety, and last service factor or application factor. So you go through this different slides and try to prepare it. So from the short note point of view, that definition of the factor of safety, factors considered for the selection of the factor of safety, define the factor of safety and the service factor, then what is the machine design, what is the basic design procedure for the machine design. So these are the some of the questions are important from the examination point of view. So in the next lecture, so we'll start with the standards and the codes, preferred series, and then we'll go for the design of that of this basic, or then we'll go for the material selection or different properties of the material. So that part we'll try to finish in the next lecture. So first we'll start with the standards and the codes, okay, then we'll start with the preferred series, then what are the different materials available, that material properties we'll see, and thereafter we'll go for the next part of this topic. So students, today we'll stop here. So thank you very much.